So here we go, off from Hawk Mountain Road. Up that road there is the Hawk Mountain Sanctuary, and then my car is hopefully safely parked here on the side. We got a little sign here, and we are heading southbound down to the Pinnacle, and then we're going to turn around, come back, and hopefully find the Seckville shelter. Finn is all gangstered out.
That's right.
Complete with the wristbands. I got some new kicks on. I don't know, we'll see how they go. And we're off. Most people, Finn and I, like for a long time too included, filled our bottles with the opening facing upstream. But we saw a dude that said, recommended not doing that and having it facing downstream. So that like less debris went into your water, and we've been doing that since, and you know, it works. That's it. We're like, I don't know, maybe like a mile in here, and it's been gravy, so we should be up to the Pinnacle
soon.
We
are about halfway up to the Pinnacle, maybe like 2 miles, 2.5 miles into a little stretch we are here. Came across a good amount of water. You know, you can see the water coming down the mountain here, and we have some easy hiking right now on this wooded road, and more coming out the other side. We just filled up, so we don't really need to get water now, but you can see from this trail the ease of our hiking right now. And there's Wags looking for snakes, which is what he does. Alright, we just got up to this clearing here. It's at the top of a ridge. As you can see, there are some clouds, and we've heard a lot of rolling thunder, so it's probably one of the worst spots we could be during a storm. But this is actually a helicopter pad on the way up to the Pinnacle that I guess people that get injured, they can medic back out from here. So we go across this here, and then it's a short mile or so to the Pinnacle. So I don't know, we might get a light show there. Can hear that thunder. Rain died down a little bit here, and we are having snack time up here at the Pinnacle. Josh, I gotta eat every 2 hours, Wagner.
True.
Is enjoying some Cheez-Its.
It's true.
I'm about to have this peanut butter power bar. And we're going to enjoy this view right here.
The breeze, man.
Yeah, the positive of these storms coming through is it probably cooled down, I would say, at least 15 degrees. And there's an awesome breeze coming through. And, I mean, you'd like to have a nice clear sky so you can get a really far view here, but,
It took all the humidity away, you know?
Yeah, the breeze and the no humidity is well worth the hazy, foggy view, in my opinion. Nice. All these days of Wag snaking, searching for snakes, finally found up at the Pinnacle here this copperhead. He looks fairly small, probably not real old. What do you think, Josh?
I don't know. Yeah, he's not too big. He's definitely a little badass, though. He's sitting there with his head looking at us.
Billy Badass Copperhead. I bet he's got a sweatband and some wrist warmers. Just like me, Billy Badass Finn. As you can see right here in this crack, Wags has found a copperhead. But if you come around to this angle here, you can't even really see that there's a snake there. This is why in the Northeast, these copperheads are so dangerous, because, you know, nature has provided them with a camouflage so effective. You probably pass dozens of these every time you're out hiking, and you would never even know it until it's too late.
In the days before the oceans drank Atlantis, Conan, destined to wear the jeweled crown of Aquilonia upon a troubled brow, I, his chronicler only, can tell you his story. Let me tell you of the days of high adventure.
So the sun just came out. Finn and I are on our way back to one of the random campsites we're going to stop at on the way back to the car. We just left the Pinnacle a little bit ago. And this has turned out to be like absolutely perfect. The humidity's all gone. There's a nice breeze. All the bugs went away. And now the sun came out. So this is it, man. This is like the perfect weather to come out.
I almost stepped on this guy. Mini trail toad. Hey. You can see how big he is in relationship to Wags's track pole. Stay off the trail, little guy. Big clumsy goofballs like me might step on you.
Go! Dig! 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 Run up the up that hill was freaking epic, man. So Finn and I.
Are you gonna hang it?
No, that's fine. So Finn and I are at camp. We took a little while to get our campfire started, but Finn, shine your light in that pit. Finn and I got our dinner in there. He's got the straight can of chunky soup. My water is in there. My backcountry teapot, which is elite. Finn and I just didn't even bother with a stove, man. That's true ultra light cooking right there, except for the 2 pound can of soup. Sirloin burger, Finn, man. All right, it's morning, and I'm about to get my coffee boiling. I just wanted to point out this little piece of gear that I got recently for Loyal Sock that I love. It's actually a titanium wet fire stove. It weighs 0.46 ounces, so less than half an ounce. And the wet fire you can't get boil on, but Esbit fits in it perfect. And for the morning, instead of clambering around trying to find wood for a little wood stove, you know, pre-coffee, this just gives a pretty instant, easy boil every time. And the important thing about it is that you have some sort of a windscreen. I didn't bring the windscreen this time, but the rocks around the campfire will work fine. So.
Alright, I just want to run through quick a little different setup than I've been using. There's the Z-Pax Cuban tarp that I have been using. But what's new about this is I tried out and slept in for the first time last night the Grand Trunk Ultralight, the camo, that I modified a little bit with the chain links, some webbing, used the tri-glides, and I added a ridge line. Still using the Lilo underquilt made for the bridge. The tapering at the feet made it a little tough to keep my legs in, but it worked out fine. And the hammock gear, the three season
Sparrow top quilt. So I had a great night's sleep. So I might shed more than a pound and just not bring the bridge from here on out.
Here it is, the Hammock Gear Cuban Four Season Tarp from Stormcrow. I went with a continuous ridge line from Dutch, and it's actually pretty awesome, man. I have a Dutch hook there, my ridge line. Coming down here, I have a prussic attached right to my tarp, which is bonded. It's pretty awesome. The bonding is pretty cool looking. Another prussic right to the tarp, and then the Dutch hook over to the tree, or the Dutch fly, I guess it is. Anyway, Stormcrow's tarp. I have this end sealed up. Pretty awesome seal. I mean, really, that's the only little gap. There's the cat cut, and then this end I just have kind of opened. And that's it. Coming inside, you can see that end is nice and sealed off. That'll be nice for when it gets cold or, you know, driving rain. And then here is the view through the Cuban from my hammock.